If you ever go to a music festival, especially a music festival in the UK, you might come across the problem that there's always lots of toilets for you to choose from. And the problem with these toilets is that they're not always that well looked after. I have been to quite a few music festivals and numerous times have I come across this problem. So the mathematical part of this problem is, let's say that you're in the queue and you get to the first toilet and you open the door and it's really not that nice. You really don't want to use that toilet. So it's okay, you can try the next toilet, you open the door, but it might be marginally better, but it's still not that good. The problem is you've got hundreds of these toilets, and how do you know which toilet to stop on and decide, yep, I'm going to use that toilet, so you don't have to try them all? There must be a set number, an optimum number we can look at. So there are two things that we do need to stick to on this problem. The first is that ideally I'm looking for the best toilet, the most hygienic, the cleanest toilet, one with plenty of toilet paper in there and hand sanitizer and has been looked after. Number two is that you can't go back to a previous toilet. There are people queuing behind you. If you reject a toilet, you can't go back to it. So I'll start with a small example where the number of toilets is actually quite small to begin with. It's a small music festival, just so we can see what's happening. So here are my three toilets. Now I'm gonna number them. 1, 2, and 3, and the numbers relate to how hygienic they are. So number one, that's the best toilet, the most hygienic. Number two, not quite as hygienic. Number three, the worst. You certainly wouldn't want to choose this one. Okay, so the toilets at the moment are lined up in this order, but it's not necessarily going to be always this order. I could have came to the toilet, and actually, number one might have been in the first position, but number three could have been second, and number two could have been third. And if we think about the number of permutations of the order of these toilets, there are actually four more. So there are 6 permutations, which is 3 factorial. So the likelihood that the first toilet you go into is the cleanest is quite slim, especially as the number of toilets gets larger. So let's say that we are always going to reject the first toilet, and then we'll choose the next best out of our options. So if we take consideration of the first example, we're going to reject toilet 1, even though it is the best. I don't know it's the best because I can't compare it yet. I then take the best possible option after that. 2, when I compare it to 1, is worse, so I can't take 2. 3, although it is also worse than 1 and 2, I have no more toilets left to choose, so unfortunately, I have to go with the worst toilet in this case.
That's a bad ending.
Bad ending. If we take the second case, again, I reject the first toilet. 3 is worse than 1, so I reject 3, and this time I have to select 2. If we move on to the third example, I reject 2. Now 1 is better than 2, so because it is better, I choose that one straight away and I stop. If I reject 2 on the fourth example, 3 is worse than 2, so I move on to the next toilet, and because it's the last toilet, I select that toilet. And then for here, I reject 3. 1 is better than 3, so I select 1 and I stop. Here I reject 3. 2 is better than 3, so this time I'd select 2 and I stop. So if we take a look at how many times I actually chose the best toilet, the most hygienic, there are 1, 2, 3. So there are 3 out of 6 chance, or a half, which is 50% chance, that I would have chosen the correct most hygienic toilet. Okay, so this is fine for when we only have 3 toilets, but what happens when we have 4? With 4 toilets, we'll now have 24 different permutations. We have to consider every single one. Now, if you work through it in the same way, we'll find that we're actually only successful on 11 out of 24 of those opportunities, which is a percentage of about 46%.
This is successful at finding the best possible toilet.
The best possible toilet, so toilet number 1. So the percentage has already decreased by only including 1 extra toilet. As n gets larger, i.e. the number of toilets gets larger, this percentage gets smaller and smaller and smaller. So the idea of rejecting the first toilet and taking the next best one after that is quite limited. We can see that as n gets large, it doesn't give us an optimal solution. So of course, at music festivals, there are hundreds of toilets. So we'd like a solution that gives us a better approximation for this percentage, to give us a better likelihood of finding the best toilet. So we're going to do it with a little bit of maths.
I'm going to stop the video here because, as you probably guessed, things are about to get pretty mathematical. So I'm going to give you a choice. If you want to see all the mathematics that leads to the answer here, go to the Numberphile 2 channel, and I've put all of the rest of this video there. And it's a bit over 15 minutes long. If you haven't got time for that, you want to just get straight to the answer, maybe you're late for a music festival yourself, stay here and we'll cut straight to the chase. But I do recommend the mathematics, it's really interesting. I think most people will follow it, and there's more really good animations from Pete. So, make your choice. I'll give you a second. Okay, so here's the deal. Once Dr. Symonds has done all the mathematics, it comes down to this. The best thing to do is to look inside 37% of the toilets. And after you hit that 37% tipping point, you choose the first toilet after that that's better than everything that came before. That gives you the best chance of ending up in the best toilet. That doesn't mean you can skip that first 37%. You've actually got to look inside them, unfortunately, so that you can make the comparison after you've gone past the tipping point, after you've gone past that 37%. To make it really simple, imagine Glastonbury, imagine 100 toilets. You've got to look inside 37, and after the 37th, pick the first one after that that's better than what came before.
So we've used the example of choosing the best toilet, but this is a famous mathematical problem that you may have seen before in a different context. You may have heard it before called the secretary problem, which is the same process. This time, you want to find the best secretary for the job, but you are going to interview n number of people, so maybe 100 people. You can only accept or reject each secretary once they be interviewed. So when do you stop interviewing those secretaries and start accepting one of them, hoping that you have the best for the job? Or another famous use of this is in the dating world. If you want to find the best partner, your soulmate out there, then how many people should you date before you should start accepting and settling down with that next person and hoping that that is the person you're supposed to be with for the rest of your life?
Thanks for watching. Just a reminder, you can still go and look at all the mathematics behind this over on Numberphile 2. We've got all the stuff worked out by Dr. Symonds and more excellent animations from Pete McPartlan. We don't actually expect people to do this at music festivals, by the way. It's just a bit of a fun twist on an old problem that everyone talks about all the time. We didn't want to make it about secretaries and dating, so why not toilets?